Okay, let me start the session from my side. So today we are about discuss about data stage, IBM data stage 11 version. So before going to the data stage to ETL, are going to that one. So what is ETL? What is architecture? So we'll discuss each and everything on today's session. So what is the difference between BI, ETL and reporting tool? If we know this one, so then we can, it's good for the data warehouse inside, it's a good. So what is the BI? Is nothing but a business intelligence. Why we are doing as a business intelligence means to improve our the business. How we're able to the improve our business is based upon apply some strategies. So we have to do some strategies, nothing but what are the current services we are providing to the customers and what are the opportunities to increase the number of the customers. And finally, we need to satisfy the customers. If we three satisfied these three categories, then we can run any business as a successful. To do this, these three above factors to satisfy, we have to do a lot of technologies we have to involve, and then we have to do so much analysis on daily basis. So part of that one daily analysis need to require, there is a some tools will be required, ETL plus reporting. So we'll concentrate about as a ETL. So ideally we'll get as a data in different ways we'll get as a data. So there are so many ways we'll real time online transaction processing the data will be generating, either it will be databases or in the Excel files or text files. These three categories we can see the data generation daily. So by taking those data and then we'll do the whatever the required data we can do that particular information, how much useful to our business, that data we can take it based upon the data, what is the current trend is going on the market. Based upon that one, high level people will take some decisions in organization level. While doing that one decisions, something will be triggered into the real time environment for their products. So based upon that one, the data, the products giving to the customers, right, it will give us more services, better services will give. So this is about as a business level. Then when it comes to the technical level, how the data will be interpreted, how the knowledge decision making, it's a different one. How the data will comes in and how the data will goes to the out. So that will be discussed in the next slide. So this is about as a business intelligence process. So while doing the business intelligence process, so there are n number of the source systems will be there. Our source will be there, either it's a files, databases, OLTP databases, or any other format. All the data should be in a structured format data. All the data should be comes in a structured format data. Once the data will comes in a structured format data, we'll take it and then as a read and then we'll populate it into a data warehouse. What is the structured format here? What is the structured format here is nothing but as a data, it should be in a tabular format. Rows and columns, it should be a proper defined. Then only our ETL tools will read efficiently, very properly, and process the data in a very fast compared to the any other things. So while doing the data from the huge volume of the data will comes in the OLTP systems. From there, ETL tool people will be extract the data in the different environments, different types of the data. Then we can read into data mods. Once the data mods we populated, either data mods or data warehouse. So here the data mods or data warehouse, the analytical data will be there. Always analytical data will comes. Analytical process data will comes. From that analytical process will be there. Again, it will be move to the reporting level. So because OLAP, OLAP is nothing but the data warehouse or data mods. So there is a useful information only will give. Who will the responsibility to move the data from OLTP to OLAP means ETL developers responsibilities. From their ETL tools, whatever we populated to the data warehouse, some reporting tools will involve, and then they will populate it into some pictorial ways of representation, they'll take it. Once the data was keep in the pictorial ways of representation, easy to understand high level, then the actual knowledge people on the data for that particular organization people will involve. Based upon that one, they'll take some decisions to improve the businesses on their organization. So while always flowing the data from bottom to top, the volume of the data will be decreases, and the taking a decision chances, right, it will be increases. So the so many teams will be involved, that entire process is called as a business intelligence process. So in that one, source side our team is there, source side people will be the scratch part will be extraction done by the ATL developers, nothing but as an extraction, transformation, loading developers. They'll take the data and then move into the from scratch to the high level. So this is about is a way of the representation. So before going to that one, so it's a, let's take it as a real-time environment. So this is the architecture of the Airtel, Bharti Airtel architecture. This is was the design. So how the real-time the data will comes, right, in the not only this one, Airtel, any organization, but this is a pure the Bharti Airtel architecture. So how the data, they divided their businesses into four categories: mobility, telemedia, business to business, and as well as the broadband services. They divided into their four categories. From that one, how they, there are n number of the source systems will be there. From that each line of business, there are so many source systems. When you say there is a MCDR or you say its revenue will be there, right? There are internally so many tables, so many databases, so many files will be there. High level, when we see to the entire organization level, this is the architecture will come. The data will come flow this one. We are the all the source systems, whatever the things, right? ETL team will be extracting the data and then populating into the warehouse. Here we are doing the n number of the extractions will do daily, n number of the transformation will be do, whatever the useful information only will populate it into the data warehouse. This entire the data will be there, right? It will be daily, approximately terabytes of the data will be processing. Terabytes of the processes will come. So daily when we do any transactions, when we do any call will be completed to speak to one customer, to the one call to the another call, there is a revenue will be generated, income, expenditure, there are a lot of stuff will be there, as well as the so many other services also will involve. So to capture entire the things, right, ETL tool is the perfect one to capture those things, and then will be populated into the warehouse. In the warehouse, it is nothing but as a data warehouse, it's nothing but as a data, it should be contains different categories of the data, different organization units of the data, means different teams in your organization. Each team, there are each organization, there are different teams will be there. Those particular data will take it and then will be maintained into one centralized places. That is called as a data warehouse. Here, the most data sensitive information, highly sensitive, secured environment will be there. From this data only, anyone can able to, if they can access this particular database, it should be the it should be collapsed to the organization. So always major security will be there. So no one will get access to directly on this particular databases. Automatically will move the data from data warehouse to data mods. It will goes whoever will be required. If it is a customer data, sales data, or some other data will be there. The data is automatically divided into the data mods. From data warehouse to data mods, it will be divided. After that, the whoever the reporting tool guys or anyone will be there, their extraction will be completed and then generate the reports. This is about as a high level about as a BI architecture. As of now, we are not enter into the data stage or ETL tools. It's the architecture will be there, business intelligence. Always the business intelligence is nothing but as a ETL plus reporting plus data mining or data presentation. This entire process is called as a business intelligence. I hope everyone cleared as of now what is a business intelligence and everything. If anyone have need more explanation on this one, let me know. Okay, let's go to the actual. So to know about as a data warehouse or ETL tools, right? First, we should have some basic knowledge on the SQL as well as the, some basic knowledge on the Unix. If to this knowledge we have available on these two technologies, Unix as well as the structured query language, then those type of the people are very good for the data stage developers. So before going to that one data stage, let's discuss about what is a data warehouse architecture, what is a data warehouse definition, then we can go for the ETL. When we see the last time, the architecture will be there, BI architecture, and here the business intelligence, the process will be the same. And the source system will be there, it's nothing but all are the source system. ETL, it's a BI, nothing but is a warehouse. Inside that one, how the data is moved to the data marts, inside is this one was there, and the reporting will be there. This is about is a generic one will be there, and this is the slide is there. This is from my organization level. I took the slides here to show to the audience. So while going to this one, right, data, same things, this particular data, real time will be implemented like this one. So what is the data warehouse definition is nothing but is a, it is nothing but a centralized, managed and integrated databases contain data from the OLTP sources. So it is nothing but, so when we go and see the definition wise, the data should be always in a structured format, always should comes in a structured format, but might be the different sources. What is the different sources? Whether it is a file, databases, or any CRM, ERP application, any different type of the source is there. We can have the capability to read that one. Once the data was read it, and the data should be any historical data, current data, anything. The time zone may be various, still we can able to read the data. So then only all the data should be contained in a structured format. Then this everything the data should be captured and then populated into the one place. This entire process is called as a data warehouse. The integration of the data between different types of the source systems of structured format data with the different time zones and then to maintain as a in a history. So daily data need to capture and then keep on loading into the warehouse to maintain the history. This all the data should be keep into one centralized warehouse on centralized one place to capture that information is called as a data warehouse. It's not very easy the entire organization level data to capture and then kept into one particular place. That is called as a data warehouse. So what is the difference between data warehouse and data mart? Once the data was populated into data warehouse, it's an organization level data will be there, but we want to give only the specific data to the specific number of the people. At that particular time, the entire data warehouse data will move into from data warehouse to the data mart. So it's a always, we can say the definition is a data mart is always as a specific data of a data warehouse. This is about the data mart. So now while doing that one, right, we'll see now this is the process will be the ETL process. There ETL process means extraction, transformation, loading the data. So what type of the tools will be available in the in market? There are n number of the ETL tools will be there, Informatica, Talent, as well as the data stage, Abhinav Show, n number of the tools will be there. IBM WebSphere Data Stage is one of the ETL tool. It's a more powerful, it's a parallel environment will be there. Those particular data will be read and then populated. Different types of the systems will be read and populated into the real-time environment. This data stage tool was developed by the IBM people. This entire process to do, always to schedule the data, automatically to run entire the process will be there, will be taken care by the ETL tool. So just know whatever I explained, the data warehouse definition is that one. Data warehouse operates at on enterprise level and contains all data used for reporting and analysis, while data mart is used by specific business department and are focused on only the particular subject area. So this is called as a data mart, and data warehouse, it's nothing but as a entire organization level. So there are different approaches will be there to populate for a data warehouse. That we'll discuss in the regular classes. So the data warehouse, how they defined as a data warehouse, each approach different. We'll see those are the things we can discuss in the latter session. So while learning ETL tool, first should know about as a SQL language is mandatory as well as a Unix. So these two are the mandatory steps to learn this one particular tool. So what will be covered as part of the entire this particular data stage? We'll cover data warehouse fundamental definitions, what is the data modeling, why the data modeling the concept will be involved. This particular, it should not relate to the data stage, but in a real time when we use organization level, ETL data warehouse will be runs on the some modeling will be required. How the modeling will be there, what is the start schema, snowflake schema, real time will be used. How that approach will be there, will explain in a overview of this entire process will explain. ETL design process will be explained, how the tools will be there, extraction, transformation will explain that one. The actually nothing to bother about the data stage versions, how the 9 version, 10 version, 11 version. This will use only the purpose of when we keep the more number of the versions in your resume, at that particular time, the people who are take the interviews, right, interviewer, they'll ask the question. So for that one, but our entire training will be run based upon the data stage 11 version. Will not give training on the 9 and 10. Will give training on the data stage version 11.3, but in real time, the latest version is 11.7, but will give as 11.3 because the more majority of the features available on the 11.3 only, that will be explained end to end as part of this entire training. So there are majorly, there are four components will be there: admin, data stage administrator, data stage director, data stage designer. these are the major components will be there. We'll explain real time. So one is about is a curriculum wide index about this one, what are the topics will be covered. So before going to this and entail the things, designer, there is a parallel job, server jobs will be there. So there are a lot of steps will cover. When we cover the designer, director, as well as the administrator. So if these three components we know how to use real time, then we are as a good data science developer. So how the things will be there, how the images will be there, let me share the one. So this is about the architecture will be there, real time data stage architecture. Earlier I shown this is a architecture for the BI process. This is about is a architecture of a data stage. So data stage can have the capability to read any type of the structured format. What is the difference between structured format and unstructured format here? Structured format always comes as a tabular format. It's a column and rows format. All should be comes in a proper environment. All should comes as a proper. One second. Structured format means all the data should becomes in a tabular format. So it's a CSV databases will comes as a structured format. When comes to the unstructured format, images, email data, voice, as well as the videos, those are will come as a unstructured format data. So the data stage tool can have the capability to read the capacity. Any structured format data, whether it's a file, table, databases, any databases. So Oracle, Teradata, or any other databases. They can able to read and then process the data and then can populate it from one type of the source to the another source. If we can read Oracle to populate Teradata, DB2 database to another database, file to databases, any. Think flexibility was available in a data stage component. So these are the components will be there: designer, director, administrator, manager will be there. But earlier in the old version, manager is a separate component. Now in the 11 versions, there should be there, right? All are integrated will be there. Manager was integrated itself only, the designer itself only. So here we can learn about, we'll explain what are the components about is it. What is the data stage designer? What is the director? What are the administrator components will be explained. So the functionalities, whatever will be there, parallel jobs, server jobs, how to read the databases, how to read the data from file, how to read the data from the table, file to table load process, table to file process. All the transformation, how to do remove duplicates, aggregation, all the components processing things will be explained here in the day-to-day regular sessions. So this is about the components, as well as we'll explain about some reusable components. Once a design was completed, it might be useful to the design different level. At that particular time, we can use this one. Shared containers concept will be there, and as well as the so these are about the advanced version is nothing but how to do nothing but slowly changing dimension concepts, how the type 1 and type 2 will implement. That is nothing but advanced parallel one. How to explain that we can take care. The next one more component is a job sequencer. Job sequencer is also the most important. Once the parallel jobs get developed, how to run the jobs in a proper manner, how to run, which one should be done first, which one should be done second. So the order of the execution jobs to be will be taken care by the job sequence. This also will comes under data center designer itself. So this is about the entire process about data speech. So as I said, we'll use the about as a we need some basic shells from shell scripts. I mean, not scripting language, need about the basics commands will be there, right? We should know. Could not, we'll use as a PPTs that one. You can go through that once. So before come to the next session, right? So the basic SQL, how the things will be there, those all the documents will share. So these are the things about as a to pre-request to learn about as a data stage one. So this is about as a demo for the data stage. So who are the next people will be joined, right? They need as a data stage software, right? That will be taken care by the coordinators. They'll configure the software. So anyone have any questions and let me know. Chaitanya, Prakash, Arnab. Yeah, it's good. You can switch the data stage because we will not write as a major big ones. We need as a basic concepts of SQL knowledge. We know that's enough. So if you can able to identify what is a table, what is a column. So those type of the structures, if you know, then it's good. So for that one, right, you don't need to go learn entire about as a SQL. It's a just we can refresh it 4 to 5 sessions will refresh about this particular technology SQL. Then after the return we can enter into the SQL part here. If you know basic, that's enough, you can learn that one. Anyone have any other questions? So right now ETL tools have a very good market. So if you have the 3 to 5 years of experience, so we can get as a salaries as a minimum 8 to 9 lakh packages will be there, and the opportunities also n number of the opportunities will be there. There are so many clients will be used, the HSBC, Airtel, JP Morgan, n number of the big companies will be there, will be using on this particular tool. Any other question? Yes, IBM data stage only have a good market. Chaitanya, Prakash, any questions?
It's good so far. Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sure, Arnab. After once you can learn this particular technology, after this course, if I'll give the so many. Sessions will be there, practice sessions will be there, will give the different types of the scenarios will be there. If you practice very well, definitely you can put as a minimum 3 years you can put as experience. How the knowledge will be available, real time 3 years experience, that particular knowledge you will also have. Yeah, real time project will explain how to handle end to end, how the data will comes, how the data will goes. End to end will one project will be explained. One case study will take for the about the Bharti Airtel project. How the case study was there? Same case study will do how to resolve and how to solve that. Arnab, anything? Any other questions? Okay, thanks everyone. We can wind up the session. Codes fees and rest of the things, right? Coordinators will be contact either Vasant or Durga soft team person will coordinate with you. Course fees, how to installation that one. That entails the Vasant from the Durga soft team, they will contact with you. If any have questions that one, please reach out with them. Thirty hours is a duration. Session always Monday to Saturday, not Friday, Monday to Saturday. Thank you, everyone. Good night and happy weekend.